Cameras, I believe, are highly underrated, especially if you're starting as a game dev. You might not consider the camera as the greatest tool in your game, or a tool that can basically change the way your entire game feels. But a good camera can make or break your game. A good camera is a camera which the player never notices. Your camera moves, rotates, tilts, pans, zooms out, shakes, follows, and defines how a player will perceive your game, how immersive it will be, how good it will be. In the beginning, most games used to have a still frame, a never-moving box, and the whole game happened inside that box. The camera never moved. But with the rise of platformers, camera became an essential part of the game, and having a good camera would mean a lot. If you have a good camera, your audience won't even notice it. And that's when you know you did the job right. Here are some of the most basic things that you can do to make your camera feel a lot better in your game. This gameplay feels a little off, doesn't it? It feels too rigid, as if the player itself is too rigid. It feels a little jittery. Something doesn't feel right. And it's because of the camera. In this scene, I have attached the camera directly to the player game object, and it follows it around every single frame. This makes the gameplay feel too rigid, and the camera will move around a lot if you do some tight maneuvers inside your game. This doesn't look good, and the player will notice it. This is a bad camera design. Making the camera follow the player's position frame by frame will never feel good, at least in most cases. What you want to do is add a little lag to your camera's movement. Your camera shouldn't snap to your player's position. Instead, it should make its way to your player in a smooth, linear fashion. This can be achieved by linear interpolation, also called as lerp. Linear interpolation will add a time frame to your camera's position. This will allow your camera to make its way to the target's location at a fixed interval. You can notice the difference right away. You can even add a dead zone. This is the area where the player can move without changing the position of the camera. It's usually advisable to make the dead zone small for fast-moving objects and vice versa. Everything depends on the intensity of your own game. The gameplay now feels a lot more smoother and polished. Lerping smoothens out the camera movement and allows the player to explore and move in 100 different ways without having the camera wobble out of control and make the player nauseous. You never want to physically hurt your player. Most game engines provide an easy way to lerp your camera to give your game a smoother finish. The Art of Screenshake. This is the title of the 44-minute video by J.W. Jan Willem from Vlambeer, a Dutch independent game studio, creators of Super Great Box. If you haven't seen the talk, I have linked it in the description. You absolutely need to see it. This talk changed the way I saw video games. It's amazing and the first step to know more about game feel and game juice. A screen shake adds that extra impact to the scene that would never have come without it. A camera shake is one of the easiest tricks in the book that you can use to instantly give your game that oomph factor. Make it feel more impactful, make it feel more striking, give it that extra energy that it needs. Exaggerate that gunshot that previously felt weak. Add power to the explosion that did not feel as powerful as before. Give that landing an extra impact. But never ever do it more than it's needed. A good camera shake is subtle. It adds the right amount of shaking that complements the impact. If you do it more, it can go from feeling satisfying to feeling nauseous. Never overdo screen shake. Experiment with it. Use different variations, low shakiness for low impacts, big shakiness for larger impacts. And never abruptly end your camera shake. Let it decrease over time, the time here being milliseconds. Your movement shouldn't end abruptly. It should sort of fizzle out. When you're working in two dimensions, your camera shake must have a translatory and a rotational movement. It should move in all the different directions, otherwise it won't feel good. I have personally made the mistake of having only translatory motion when shooting my gun and restricting the camera shake to just one axis. It feels like my camera just moves back every time I shoot. Adding a bit of a rotation and motion in all the axes makes the shake far more satisfactory. For 3D, rotate the camera for shaking. Don't add translation motion. It doesn't work well with the 3D perspective, and translatory motion can also make the camera clip into an object that sits beside the player, which is the last thing that you want to do. Your camera movement can be highly dynamic. You can animate your camera in a million different ways and emphasize your gameplay a lot better. You can zoom out to make your player feel insignificant, or you can zoom out to reveal a giant enemy. You can zoom in to make the player feel more claustrophobic and give the feeling of being in a confined space. You can zoom in on the player before a special attack to put more impact on it. You can move the camera around to tip the player to their next objective, as seen in puzzle games. And you can do this.
Little fake! Get
up! There is so much that you can do with a dynamic camera that you cannot do with a boring static one. One of the first instances of a dynamic interactable camera design was seen in Super Mario 64. A revolutionary game of its time, its camera system could anticipate obstacles and move accordingly. One of the best uses of a dynamic camera, I believe, is in an action-packed fighting game. The instant zooms in and zooms out, the closing in on the player, the dynamic movement of the camera to get both the players in one scene, everything. Everything leads to a scene far better than any action movie ever. You can also make use of your camera's field of view to exaggerate speed, increase it to lower motion sickness in players, use it to emphasize something in your gameplay, among other things. Go check out your favorite games. Notice how they dynamically implement their cameras. Get inspired and create something new. Mark Brown from Game Maker's Toolkit has an excellent talk on the best dynamic cameras seen throughout video game history. Game design has a lot in common with cinematography. You are creating a movie where you can control the hero. And here the director and the cameraman, both of them are you and you alone. The rule of thirds is one of the most popular golden rules in cinematography and photography. The basic principle behind the rule of thirds is that your scene looks a lot better if you place your subject on the thirds of your frame. What I mean by this is when you put your main subject, in your case the player, on any of these four intersecting points on the screen, it looks way better. A lot of games do this, and it will instantly make your game feel good. The science behind this is that framing your character in the center of the screen gives less time for the audience to process the background, as your subject is right in the middle. But having them a bit off-center, closer to one of the four points, the audience can take in your subject and then wander their eyes over to the background, creating a sort of a conversation between the eyes of the audience, their subject, and the environment they are in. On a final note, I would like to say that don't follow everything that I just said. Or rather, don't follow everything blindly. You don't have to add lerp if your gameplay requires snapping camera positions at an instant. You don't have to add in screenshake if you're building a VR game. Not every game requires a dynamic camera. There are a lot of games that use a simple static camera that doesn't move around much. If your game doesn't need it, don't spend valuable time doing it. If your game needs it, then experiment. Experiment a lot. Use playtesters to see if the camera movement is satisfying for players or not. Your journey doesn't end here. I have a video on how you can use Cinemachine in your Unity project to achieve these camera tricks easily. I have also linked various talks on camera design in the description below. And I would urge all of you to watch them all to know more about the subject. Subscribe for more upcoming similar videos on game design and development. Follow me on Twitter for the latest updates. Until next time.